Get the Photoshop up. So we have my Photoshop. Going to start doing some sketching. Yes, I do. Crystal Dragon, yes. Alright. So, can you guys still kind of hear the music, or...
I just want to know if it's,
you know, suitable. Just so that you can kind of still hear it, but it's not too, like... I don't want it to get too boring up in there. Well, I'm sketching a bunch of nonsense. Okay. Good. I'm glad everything sounds good. Alright. Let's do some awesome sketching. Now, this is going to be silhouette style that I will be working in. And I definitely like this style for making the creatures because I find it to be quick, and quick is nice. So we're gonna go quick. And we're not gonna use this gray color, we're gonna use a semi-dark, not too dark, but dark enough to add some shadow and stuff after. Alright, now for the little guys. So I have some mushroom ideas, like, let's see. I have some ideas for the mushrooms and stuff, I think. Why is this so slow? I don't like that. Let's make sure nothing else is running. Just music. Probably because I'm streaming at a higher res, so it might be a little laggy. But I mean, it seems to be going okay. So like little monster guy. Kind of scribble on a little. Yeah, see, it's lagging. Ugh, that sucks. Bothers me so much. Cause I can paint faster than that, so. So what we're doing is we're creating an awkward looking mushroom thing. Mushroom. It's great for night shift. Good, I'm glad it helps. You know, seems to have some kind of stuff coming out of his head over here. That's an interesting thingy. We'll just leave that weird spikes. Leave those there. Maybe he has arms. Let's see. Very interesting mushroom thing. Like a strange mushroom. Maybe he has little mushrooms growing out of him. Don't know how this mushroom thing would sprout in the world of Phoenix, but let's just pretend. Let's just pretend. Seems like he's got some kind of wire, not wires, but maybe like, kind of see a face coming out there. Yeah, we'll stick to that. Oh, you gotta go. Oh, okay, Crystal. RuPaul's Drag Race. Hey, that would be really fun. Like a really cool looking drag queen thing. So we got this, like, strange-looking little creature. That's one. We can work with him, right? And let's do another one. Let's do... do another little creature. Maybe this one's, like, a tall one, right? You know, like... weird mushroom. Yeah, it's gonna be a... maybe it has like plant things coming out of it, you know, like almost like a root, like a ginger root. Headbanging to the music. Okay, cool. All right, Paul. I see what you're saying. Drag shroom. Yes. Okay, so we have some kind of weird creature here. How would this attack like, even him, it's just kind of like, what would he do to you? Like, poison you? And this guy seems like... let's give him, like, a weird chin. Like, maybe it has a nose or something. Like that. Maybe it's wearing a hat. Looks like, you know. Creepy looking thing. I mean, I don't know, a mushroom with a staff is kind of, you know, let's go back. I don't like the chin. Whatever I'm creating over that, I don't like. Keep it to just the mushroom head. Maybe he has like a tail or something that like, or, oh, you know what? No. He has like long arms that come out. And he, like, whips you. Your ass gets whipped. Oh my god. So, alright, so if he attacks you with that, your ass gets whipped with that. Poison gas, like in, like the mushrooms in Dark Souls, yeah. Minecraft, yes. Devil Shroom. Green Flamer, hey. Playing too much Fortnite. I know, my little brother's addicted to that game. So, welcome guys. We got 8 watchers up in here. It's getting a little crazy. No, I'm just kidding. Alright, so we have this guy. Right? He looks kind of neat. Who knows what the hell he can do. Maybe I can... I don't know. He looks like he definitely releases some kind of spores, though, right? Like this looks like it releases spores. So that's kind of fun. I'm sure we can create some really crazy looking shit. But let's move over and let's do another one. Because we're going to make them look pretty cool after. So I'll show you guys how I'm going to do that. All right. So now we need... let's see. Maybe a Venus flytrap one. Venus flytrap thingies are like creepy. Like plants that eat things that are alive are insane to me. There's so many creepy plants. Like there's one plant. Oops. There is one plant that literally will like. It just sits there and it has some kind of fluid in the inside or whatever, and it just like bugs just fall inside of it. And I'm mesmerized by that. Like, I mean, it just, like... And then it kills you, like, as you're in it. And I think that's... kind of sick. Like, it just, like... And then it feeds off of it. And then the flies... Venus flytrap. I don't know if this is a Venus flytrap, but... It's something. It's definitely some kind of weird thing. I should probably look at a Venus flytrap, but I don't want to be too inspired by... I don't want to be too corrupted, I guess, by some things. Like, I want to have an idea of what... I mean, you should be looking at stuff, but it would make it easier. Doesn't really look like a Venus flytrap. I don't know what I'm creating. Should probably not do this one. I'm deleting it. I'm gonna do a different one. I'm gonna make it more. I'm thinking too hard about it. I should just do it. Just gotta let it. Just let it happen, you know? Sometimes when you think too hard about it, silhouettes help me. Alright, let's see. It's kind of like a dinosaur. Pitcher plant. Ah. Vase shape. Yeah, you guys know what I'm talking about. Hey, Christopher Polk. What's up? Okay, so... I don't know what I'm doing. Sometimes, though, He's a little too big. I'm gonna make him smaller so that way I don't get too caught up in this. That way it's not too hard to produce the design. Here we go. Okay, so maybe he's like little leaves or something. Like he's like... That's his feet. These things just walk around like this. Madness. Uh-oh, it's gonna all feel black. Here we go. Go back. Okay. Left a hole there. Like, what are we creating? Like, what is this thing? Like, maybe it's... Looks like it has a stomach. Butt. It's human. This is some crazy shit. I don't know what this is. Looks like he's dancing. Sticking up the neck a little. Maybe he like moves, you know, like in a weird like zigzaggy. It's like cute. I don't know, I'm gonna... Who knows what this thing is, though? Alright. We're done with this little guy. We shouldn't spend too much time on just some, like, basic... I'll make him kind of small. I feel like he's kind of small. Just funny to me. I don't know. Seeing stars. Moves like a snake. Super soaking. Oh man. He got kicked out in round two. Yeah, he does. Does kind of think that. He does look like he kind of thinks it's fabulous. Alright, let's do another one. Let's see. We need something weird. I mean, like, we don't already have weird. we need some more mushroom things. I want... Maybe like this. this as like its eyes. It's kind of giving everybody like mushrooms. Pathetic. It just looks too pathetic. I don't know. It's like a sad mushroom. Now, you know what? Something that's like floating. What about a flying plant? What the hell did I just draw? My computer's lagging. Let's take him and shrink him. We'll give it some roots. This is still the ugliest one. Maybe that's his arms. He attacks you with mushroom powers. Mushroom powers. This one could definitely be like a diseased one though. Like, a diseased, I don't know about diseased, but probably like poisons you. Flies somehow. Somehow that floats. I don't know. I'll come up with some reasons. It needs something more though. Maybe he punches you. It's like a boxer. Like, that would be kind of funny. He's a boxer. Because we're talking about boxing and stuff, so I'm gonna make him like a boxer. Give him boxing gloves. He punches you. Yeah, maybe it is. Maybe he doesn't float, but he, like, hovers. Yeah, the punching. All right, let's see. Like a chubby mushroom. Be like kind of buff. I don't know where I'm going with this guy. I'm seeing something. Or he could have, like, arms that come down like this. Let's give that a shot. Yeah, that's what I was thinking, Leslie, when I saw it. I can, like he's still a mushroom, but at the same time, an alien. Too big right now because my computer is like there we go. It looks like he's wearing punching gloves. Blue gold dress all over again. Okay. I think this is enough characters for now. I honestly don't think we should have to worry about doing any more. And so far the video is... What are we in? What are we at? Like, I don't know. It's not telling me. Oh, shit. Take too long to make these guys, right? So that's four characters, and we're going to start making some stuff. So maybe he does have it. He might have some stuff hanging from him. Who knows? I might change that, but. Alright, so let's go work with this guy. Oh shit. Select him. Still don't know if I want to use that guy, but we'll see what we can do about his face. Okay. So these are our characters. Time to get to the fun stuff. Eye of the Tiger will come on next. I know Oh man. I love this music. It is seriously like my favorite kind of music. Alright. So we got this guy. Let's do this. I'm just gonna do this. I'm gonna use a circle brush. Save some space, just doing that won't be so slow. Okay. Oh, no, I didn't want to do that. For a good brush that I can use. Hmm. music is gone to a place that I don't even know anymore. Yes, Paul, yes. It's like the best. Okay, so let's see where this guy is. Oops, did not want to do that. Looking pretty cookie cutter. I hate this brush. I absolutely hate it. Music is so 80s tonight right now. Yeah, I'm not a fan of the brush, so I'm gonna go back to my other brush. Better. Oh yeah. What the hell? The only thing that sucks right now is that my computer is slow and I'm not liking it. It's because I'm working off, working off my laptop. Shouldn't have had it highlighted like that when I did this. Ooh, it is too slow. It's so choppy, I can't do it. I should be using a smaller file. We work off 200 dpi. I don't like using that small amount, but or I could have changed the pixels. We didn't need no 300 dpi, to be honest. It's big enough. Might be able to work a little easy. Oh yeah, that's better. flow is much better now. Stuff's too stiff for me. I can't work. Okay. What's going on with this little creature? Ooh, EGX. Probably not. what the? Not supposed to come out that top. Lagging. It's still lagging. Oh, it's driving me nuts. I can't draw when it lags. Maybe he has like a vine or something. I am Groot. This is really lagging for me. Oh shit. Back to this character. Really slow. Like how his knees almost kind of buckle. Okay. Come on. My computer doesn't want to do this. Feel as I can without this causing too much of a lag, but I'm having some lagging issues, which is making my work suffer. With him for now. I don't even know if I'll use him, but I think he's kind of interesting. So we'll move on to this guy. You know what? We can add some color. So. No, I don't want to get on my PC because I can't sit there for an hour. My back is killing me. So I'm just doing kind of like, just my own thing. Just chilling on the couch because I really don't feel like sitting over there. I think it's going to be very painful. Green. Okay. Oh, this is this. Kind of getting like some color, trying to work it into the character, but right now I'm just erasing a lot of the excess I didn't really want. Kind of the top glowing a little bit. I don't know, that's kind of neat. Like, I'm gonna go with that. Gonna let that stay. The idea of it glowing is a little neat to me. Nice. Okay, that I think looks really good enough for me to. Oops. Let it fade. Sometimes letting something fade in the back is nice. Sometimes I don't even know if I want to use it. With the twin thing. And welcome. I just noticed you were here. I'm sorry if I sound a little tired or whatever. I've been working all day, so I kind of I'm trying. Forgive me. Okay, so we have this. Now we're gonna do him. I mean, it's coming along, you know. So we have some weird creatures over here, for those just joining, but maybe we can try to do this guy a little bit faster. Hopefully my computer is not going to start lagging on me. What I'll do next time is not do so many characters in a row. I'll just have to open up separate files or something and do it that way. I think that's probably the best way. Let's get this. Ooh, I did not want to do that. I just made a dot. All right, and let's get this guy now. So we're working on him, and we don't really know what he has in store for us. Could be anything. I don't know what this thing is, but let's see. Nope, that's not what I want to do. Okay, I'm gonna just use the burn tool first. That way we can. Oh, I'm on the wrong layer. No wonder why that's not working. Okay, so he would have a lot of shadow happening under here. Let's just get. So I feel like he would look like this. He or she. This thing could be a. Don't really know, man. Don't know. Okay. Interesting. Alright, let's get some darker tones up in here. And we'll use my good brush this time. I won't lag. What are you doing? That's my kitty. Oh. thinking up some weird designs here, so maybe something. That really kind of weird bone thing going on over here. How is your game coming along? Oh, it's coming along really well, actually. Like, I'm very happy with the way everything is coming out, and it's just really exciting. Like, all of it's really exciting. It's a super exciting experience that I'm able to do this, and it makes me really happy. I think this game definitely makes me happy working on it. I wouldn't want to be doing anything else, to be honest. Like, I really like writing and stuff, but I think there's something about this. Like, just working on this game is the most fun experience for me, and I don't really like want to do anything else but this. It's exciting. Oh, a drawing tablet. I am using a Wacom tablet at the moment, but it's not a tablet that you draw on the screen directly. It works more like a mouse, and it's very difficult. Sometimes there's little bugs, like you can get like a jagged edge or something like that, and those are not fun. So I tend to, you know, have to deal with that with this tablet specifically. But I do usually use my on-screen tablet, where you draw directly onto the screen, and it's so much easier. But that one's at my computer. I'm at my laptop right now, and I'm just doing some basic creature designs, and I figured I could do it here and just stream for you guys. Much more comfortable in the living room. So I'm like trying to do that way, but who knows? I feel like, I don't know, maybe I'll have to eventually go back to the other room when I do some of my bigger stuff. And that will be soon, I'm sure. I'm using the wrong color. That's my... So we're gonna give him some kind of a weird thing going on here. Trying to make it so that way it I think I got it. I'm making it very different from the way I thought I would, but let's see. You know, just sometimes you never know how something's gonna turn out. So you gotta just play your luck at it, I guess. Play your luck at it. But I mean, it's all about when you're doing concept anyway, it's all about really just not knowing what you're doing. So just kind of doing whatever comes to mind and then dealing with it. I like to use this tool, the dodge tool, just to get some highlights. I'm not sure if that's gonna do what I want, but okay, yeah, that worked. Yeah, sometimes it works for some things, other times it doesn't. nice and shiny. Kind of leave it like that. I think though them some designs. My cat probably thinks it's time for food. It actually is time for food. Poor kitty. Lawless is coming to MegaCon in Florida, and I'm pretty much freaking out at this point because it's Lucy Lawless. I'm excited. She will be here next week. It's pretty awesome to me. Thank you. neighbors upstairs drive me nuts. They stomp around all day long. Of course I'm going to do the Xenogall. It looks like a weird helmet. It does. That's cool though, because it's going to work as like a... as an interesting little piece, so... Right now... they have some kind of... mushrooms have these. Because Kitty is hungry. And she feeds him. Like, I don't feed him. Mama is okay, obviously. Little kitty. She's the mummy. I know what you're all thinking. Animal people. Sometimes it's a little bit like too set to the soft. Happening. I don't even hear any music. There we go. Mm-hmm. zoom out, take a little look at what we're creating here. It's coming to life, you know, for a silhouette. Kitty has been very needy for, like, since this morning. Yeah, I was thinking it does look a bit like a dolphin or a whale. I kind of like mixing it. Hey, Shadow Watcher. What's up? Ooh. That's interesting. All right, we're going to zoom up a little bit more now. Probably gives off some kind of spore or something. Thank you. So this is that. Now let's add a little color and see where we go. Now these things I feel like can be all sorts of different like weird colors. I think this might stay green, but when doing different colors, it's like, you know, for creatures, like I can change the colors and make them different colors, but. All right, Leslie. Don't really know what it looks like, but I'm just gonna I mean that's okay because we don't need to care really. It's just, it's a creature, you kill it, and it's a mushroom thing. It's a weird mushroom thing. Cyberpunk. It's like a cyberpunk mushroom. We have went to the place and done the thing. Okay. Let's clean him up. Looks good. Okay, we have black and white. people like glow around, you know, white areas. It makes it look like color is just like light is bouncing off of them. All right, so that's a second one. Second creature down. Possible fighting creatures right here. Possible creatures that will go in that game. I really kind of like this one. I think it's kind of weird. Very interesting, weird ass thing. It's a weird ass thing. Look at it. Look at it. Fuck. Okay. Looks like it's like waving or something. It's funny looking. It's good. It's kind of cool. Use some more highlight, but we'll just go with that for now. His arms are like weird things that look like they smack you. They smack your ass. Okay. This, I seriously am so tempted to just want to get rid of because it's kind of hilarious looking. I don't know. Maybe we can just move on to this guy. Like, part of me's like, do it. For the laughs. But the other part of me is like, don't do it, Ginger. Don't do it. We're gonna move him. We're gonna focus on this guy. Let's not embarrass ourselves tonight, Ginger. Okay. I'm gonna move. Crap. Oh shit, I might do that. What am I? This over, and then I'm gonna move this guy over, and then I'm gonna just crop it. Okay, because I'm trying to save some space so my computer doesn't overload. I mean, coming out nice. Not bad. Two characters down, yo. And they look pretty sweet, so. Not too bad. For some silhouettes, I mean. I don't normally use this technique, but this isn't, like, a technique that I'm learning to do. And I like how quick it is to kind of just come up with weird shit. And I love the look of it after. Like, I feel like it kind of just goes really well. Yeah, it's very detailed. They're pretty much ready to be just placed into the game and used for battle and animated. Mr. Fab. No, he's out. He's like... the Mr. Fab plant. Like, he tried. Like, here he is right there. I mean, you could combine him with, like, another character. Who knows? Like, maybe I can create, like, a weird version. But let's work with this creepy thing. Another mushroom head thing. So, I'm probably going to use the same technique that I used here. Yeah. And this is the boxing guy. So he looks like he punches you with... You know what? Maybe like some kind of plant stuff. You know, like roots or... Oh, yeah. Roots. That's what we'll do. Okay. So, as always, I use black and white first. I'm going to use our black and white. Because then you can add color to anything. Like, you know, it's pretty much... This is the guy that looks like he has like a face right here. Yeah. He also has that spinal thing going on. Gonna look kind of neat with some like vines and stuff coming out of it. I think we'll make him green. And since this is such a hard edge, I will soften it up just so I can do some. Kitty still hasn't eaten. Come on, Michaela. She's gotta come out and help my kitty. Kitty is hungry. This is an important thing. Mushroom guy is gonna have some kind of weird like veins and stuff coming out of him. Kayla must be playing video games. Creating some weird ass stuff there. So like he has fingers or something, but he doesn't. It could just, like, come out into that. Kayla, the kitty's hungry. Now let's go into some lightning now. Now we're gonna save because I have not saved. Like, don't do this at home, my friend. Always save. Don't be like me. That is, like, seriously my first time saving. Sculpt the creep show, Dad. Oh, I can sculpt a lot of things. Mutated kitty creature. Yeah. Oh, we can do that. Yeah, because, I mean, they would be totally mutated by this point. Are you seeing my little creatures?
Yeah.
Look at this one.
Whoa.
I know, it's kind of fun. We're just gonna select this color here because I really want to bring that out. This one's like, we can make this one like a female. I am doing this style and technique is the better I'm getting at it. Like, I'm finding myself just starting to really see what I'm doing with this. the way you can just kind of bring creatures out to me from like a just a silhouette is kind of awesome, actually. Not Algae Productions. I have not played God of War, but that name is interesting. Not Algae Productions. Huge mutated tiger, Leslie. That's... yes. That is something I can definitely do. Yeah, no, tigers would be totally... yeah, no, tigers would be gone from Phoenix. It's something I can do. But it's not gonna be. Getting some delay here, so I'm screwing up. It shouldn't be coming up that quick. Still doing it. I'm gonna have to use my other brush for that. Needs to be done with the proper brush. Make Monster Mushroom Kingdom Toad. anyone else think Yoshi from Mario Brothers looks like the Creepshow dad? That's hilarious. I think so. So we're kind of getting somewhere with this design. Stomach is not looking the way I want it to, so I'm gonna go into liquefy. Hopefully my computer doesn't crash. Can you make it a little cooler in here? Yeah. Since we are making it female, might as well enhance some of the female parts. Interesting what I just did. What did I just do? Hey, Abby. We're creating very interesting looking creatures, as you can see. So now we can add some nice highlights just to see where we're going here. Too hard. I'm gonna lighten that up. Nope. Softer brush. I feel like this part needs to be kind of shiny. Oh no, the sequel to Phoenix has not come out yet. That will be coming out soon. In like, probably, like a little after. Probably next year for that one. Almost done. doing these tiny details that are really not fully necessary, but I'm kind of interested in doing it. These weird ass creatures I'm creating. Hey, Erica. All right, see you, Slimer. Thanks for joining. Oh, thank you, Martian. Martian Le Monster. I mean, there's some more little details I can do, but I think I just want to color it and see what happens, you know? See where we can take our new friend here. All right, so these are our characters. Quick save. The save button. There we go. guys. You guys lasted this whole time. That's like, I mean, I'm sure some of you guys popped in and out, but the heads remind you of Morrowind. Yes, Eric, I love Morrowind. You know how much I love mushrooms. Like, seriously. Speaking of Morrowind, may the mullet of Maria be with you. The mullet of Maria. Oh my god, yes. Oh my god, so funny. Yeah. That's hilarious. Okay, I'm getting back to work. Okay. I'm almost done. I just want to like finish this up. All right, so we're going to make him. We did. This guy over here is green. This guy over here has got like a Morrowind feel to him, and maybe we can do like a red. No, we kind of get that color. Maybe like a blue. Yeah, let's do it. Alright, we'll start with yellow though. Just to give it some highlight. And we'll do a nice soft brush. Because doing the soft brush is very nice. Okay, that's our color. Do a tube overlay. And here we go. Now we can totally turn up that color. That's too much. Yeah, I like to do it nice. Ooh, oh. To be a little fuzzier. That's why. Kind of almost want your coloring to be like a airbrush feel, you know? Like. Start with the yellow and then build it up into some green or blue. There we go. Okay. Into this. I like this teal color. Because we're using a nice teal, it will make it seem green. And then we're gonna shrink the brush a little bit. And let's go into a darker blue. Do some of the undertones here. Some of these mushrooms can be glowing a little bit, because in my book I actually talk about how they do that. So, I have some ideas for these mushrooms. I don't know why I just did that voice. Oh my god, I must be getting tired. I started doing all my weird voices when I started getting tired. What time is it? It's 10:30. I can still go off and play a video game. That's. Look at all the work I've done today. I have designed so many things today. I feel accomplished. I'm just cleaning them up. And honestly, leaving some of that glow. Off the edge of the part here. Makes it look nice. Oh, come back. Yeah, let that glow a little bit. I'm fine with that. Okay, so now let's do another layer, and I have something in mind for this little guy. I'm gonna use a brush. This will be fun. Time to do something. Time to do something that doesn't make any sense. No, it does. It does make sense. Since this is kind of like a weird mushroom thingy, my mushrooms do glow, so some of them glow will be quite nice. I don't know why I'm doing this part, but I'm just gonna play around. See what happens, right? Some of their veins glow, like. Like it pulls through the veins. Like it's oozing into this weird orb. I mean, this weird rock structure. And then we can make some of this glow here. Make it all glow. I just want it to glow. Oop, that's too much glow. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make it glow and it's gonna look nice. Just gave it an ear. No, we shouldn't do that to it. Hasn't it had a rough life as it is? It's like a cyberpunk mushroom. This poor mushroom has seen better days. No, I'm definitely getting tired. No, you know what? I don't like that vein. Take it away. This is a definite radiated, like, creature. It's been radiated. Exactly know what it does, but it does the thing. It just does. It is the thing. It is the thing of all things. Let's make these pots glow. It's kind of cool looking at it glow, you know, like strange neck pots that glow. Strange part of its brain that glows. Okay, now that we've added a lot of awesome glow, And I better stop before I keep adding glow and I'm gonna make it super glowy. Because I love that shit. Okay, now let's add the effect. Let's do it. Here we go. Time to make it. Here we go. Time to make it glow. Oh my god, I can't believe I just did that voice. Like, here it comes. Oh, look at that glow. Okay, but wait, now we gotta. Whoa. Just got super glowy. I could not keep up with what I was doing. We're gonna do it different. We're gonna make it more color. It's to be closer to the teal color, I think. Green's not big enough. Okay. I think. Whoa. That's super glowy. Yeah, we'll keep it at 2. Okay, some part here doesn't like. It doesn't want to look good, so. Gonna delete a little bit of that glow. Doesn't make any sense, you know? On some areas where it's just sticking out. Okay. That's a good glow. We got a good glow going, guys. And there we go. I want this guy to glow now. And this one. I want them all to glow. God. On a random note, you have a really soothing voice. Combination of that and the music in the background is about to make me fall asleep. You know, that's funny you say that, Martian, because I watch a guy on here too, and he's an artist, he always puts me to sleep, but everything he says, I mean, he's the one pretty much teaching me a lot of these techniques, is so, it's like everything he says is so genius, and he's teaching these amazing things, but I'm falling asleep, and it's not because what he's teaching is boring, it's just, you know, so relaxing, I guess, and he makes me sleepy. Like, I could sleep, and then I feel like I'm always, like, super refreshed after. Okay, so these are our guys. Look at these guys. These girls. This one looks like it will, like, eat you. I don't know. I want it to eat people. It just consumes you. This one whips your ass. This one beats your ass. This one, like, I don't know. I think this one just dances. It should just dance. And it kills you if it, like, does a certain move of dance moves. It has a dance-off with you. Hey, Crystal Dragon. Oh, it's your birthday? Or it's almost your birthday. Well, congratulations and happy early birthday if it's just starting to become your birthday almost. If it is your birthday, then happy birthday. Maybe I can sing like a weird happy birthday song to like to this creepy music. No, I can't. I probably can't do that. But happy birthday, and I hope that you have a good time. If I don't come back on during the time, but I probably will though. I'm gonna be doing a lot of this because I have a lot of creatures I need to design, and I think we're gonna go with this method because I'm really enjoying it, so this is definitely happening. Yeah, 1 in 3 do look pregnant, but that's okay, I want them to. I want them to look kind of pregnant. This one's just gonna, like, give birth to a bunch of spores at any moment and kill you. May 20th. Ah, that's, yes, and that definitely is coming up soon. Feel like I need to fix the stomach a little. I don't like these lines that I drew here. It makes it look, I don't know, makes it look weird. But I'm getting it. I'm getting this. Look how we started off here. You can tell the details didn't work that well, you know? So I might have to go back in there after and fix some of that. But we really got really got pretty detailed in these guys. Like, I think these two came out pretty good. Especially for the fact that they're just silhouettes at the beginning. I mean, now look at them. Now they're full-on characters that we designed. I say it's we. I feel like you guys are part of it. So thank you for being part of it, and helping me out and being part of the chat and just talking and chatting with everybody, and has been fun. And you guys, I like how you guys talk to each other about stuff. Ah, that would be cool, Crystal. So yeah, no, just if you want to support my work, I have my Patreon right here, and my Twitter is just right there, and Facebook too, but I'm not really, I like go on my Facebook, but my Twitter, I post a lot of fun stuff about my game, and my Patreon, I will post exclusive content, and stuff like this gets uploaded. I have tutorial videos, and a lot of stuff that I don't share on some of the other pages, so, I just want to thank my patrons as well all the time. They are fantastic for supporting me and helping me bring this game to life. So I think I'm going to call it a night and let you guys enjoy and have fun watching this video again if you were late and you want to watch it again in the future. But yeah, like, this is how you would do some concept art for... I mean, this is mostly almost fine-tuning. You can take these characters right now and just stick them in the game and use them for animation and whatever you want. Make 3D models of them. But for me, it's going to be some animation. And yeah, and these are the Phoenix fights in the game. So I want to thank you guys for being here. Glass of wine sounds fantastic, actually. Yeah, I probably might go have one of that, and might have some of that while I play some video games and chill out and have, you know, relax a little bit. So yeah, you guys have a great night, day, wherever you are in the world, and I will see you all again. Alright, bye. Oh, and I'll probably be on tomorrow. So bye, catch you later.